Welcome to my little music studio. It's right here with a MacBook Air 2012 and the keyboard here. So, and this music app that you see on the screen, which is completely in the browser. All the sounds are generated in the browser. We can, for example, start the synthesizer right now and we can play some sounds. Change the sound here. We have the bass, have this lead, which is quite cool. And this organ, for example. And the source code for these sounds are here. So the organ is down here. For all the code for rendering this organ is actually this one. It's assembly script, so it's compiled to WebAssembly on the fly in the browser. And code on the left side is the actual song. So you can see all the notes here. And if you start the sequencer and play. That's the song. You can go into the website and listen to it if you want, but right now I just want to show you how to use Git, because this is code and what would be more convenient for versioning than using Git in the browser. And of course this has a Git client, so we can create a test comment. And if we save the file now, we see that we get the commit and sync button here. And so we see there's some changes. It's the test comment here. And so we say proceed, and then it pushes, commits, and pushes it to the server. And if we then go to the CLI here, it's a terminal, and we can actually try to git pull. And we will see that there were some changes to this song file. And if we look at git log, you can see that we got the comment in here, and we can of course just see that the comment is here. So that's it, and this is of course stored entirely in the browser, in the client. It's a client-side storage. So if we go in here in the application, just have to wait a little bit, because this is an old computer, it's quite slow, so take some time for this to show. But then you can actually see that in the index.db here, which is the mscripting file system, you can see all the files stored here locally, right? So here we have all the entire file system stored locally. And if we go back to the service worker and we say that now we want to run this offline, we can still see that, okay, it still loads, and it loads our code and everything. And we can also run git commands from in here just by calling into the git worker. And so we can, for example, write call main status, and then we can see there are no changes right now, but if we make a change here, you will see that there are things going on here, and status will show this, and that's of course while we get this commit and sync button, and we undo, and then there's nothing right now. So we get this message here because we haven't started the sequencer, and we can of course do that.